Hi guys, so today I thought I might do a bit of a, what's it called, vlog kind of thing. Probably won't be much of a vlog because, to be honest, I'm not very good at this, but anyway, so as you probably can't, well, you probably can tell because there's stuff everywhere, but I'm down at the horse's paddock. Just got down here a few minutes ago because we had to shift some hay into next door and I brought some feed and stuff for the horses. So it is a Thursday. I am not at school. So hopefully it will be good. But yeah, I am not at school because I'm too cool for school. So I just finished. I'm gonna ride Tex first. I don't know if you can see her. Ooh. Oh, she's not looking at us. Tex. She's not wanting anything to do. She's trying to eat. I'm going to ride. Oh god, the sun. The sun is not good. You probably can't tell. Texie, I'm gonna ride her first. I've just finished brushing her and doing all that, so I've just got to tack her up. And yeah, so I'll see you guys soon. Bye. So, sorry. So we've got the pony all tacked up, and she's not actually excited about this, if her ears pointed. She's just trying to find Kelly. But a few of you have been asking what gear I use, so I thought I'd just quickly go over what I use on a normal day-to-day ride. And yeah, so we'll start over here. My saddle is a status. Whatever you want to say it. It's a Status S4U Fit Close Contact Saddle. And it's a 17 inch, I believe. Yeah, I think so. And I love this saddle, it's pretty good. It has the changeable gullet and all that in it, so when I do get Tex a Western saddle, Callie can have this saddle, so it's really good. My stirrups, I wouldn't be able to tell you what they are. They're just stirrups. I don't think they have a real big brand. Stirrup leathers are just some, I think Enzo McGriff. Griff's Enzo in a, it's not gonna focus. 36 inch or 90 centimeter. She's got a really small tummy, so I have this 5-point on her. I think it's an Enzo brand again. Her blue saddle blanket is Zilko or Roma. No, I think it's Zilko. Half pad, might be Enzo again actually. Yeah, I think it's Enzo again. I ride in open front boots a lot of the time. So they just look like this. They're the, I think it's called like Plocker Ponies, something like that, but they're just black, and then they have a bit of pink at the back there. It's better, it's in my shade, and then obviously the front of them, which you can't really see because of the sun. It's just that silly time of the day. That's her breastplate. Her bridle is, I don't actually know the full, like the actual brand of it, because it was a really expensive bridle actually. It was nearly $100. But it was, before I put the hackamore and stuff on it, it was a figure eight or grackle, whatever you want to call it. And I took all that off because obviously she doesn't ride in a bit. But yeah, so I can't remember what brand it was. It wasn't really a flash, like real flash kind of brand, but yeah. Then she's just got her typical diamond brow band. Pony, come here, good girl. And then her hackamore, which doesn't have a brand. I don't think many hackamores have a brand. That's just her typical kind of tack up, what she wears. And that's Callie over there. But yeah, I'm just about to get on and go, so yeah, these are Kel. Some of you have been asking if I still have her. Yep, I do. She's gonna probably be here for all winter and maybe spring. Then I might sell her, might not, might keep her. Hey girl. But yeah, so I'm about to get on and I'll see you guys soon.
Like a bullet train, moving like the speed of sound. Feet can't keep on the ground. Can't stay in one place. Keep moving like a bullet train, like a bullet train. Moving like the speed of sound. We can keep on the ground. Can't stay in one place. Keep moving like.
So, we're back from riding Turks. I'll admit it was pretty horrible. She wasn't very responsive at all. You probably can tell in the videos. There was just no control at all. Like, she wasn't bad, like, she's always been like that. It's quite hard doing flat work and stuff with her, or doing, you know, poncy English stuff. Cut it out. Tex! She's just rubbing her bridle up in the gate. Yeah, it's pretty hard to do English stuff with her because she's not an English horse. And I've been trying to save up for the Western Saddle, but it's just something I can't afford at the moment. Don't know if I ever will be able to afford, maybe when I have a proper job and stuff. And stuff, but yeah, it just, nothing was going to plan. We did a couple of jumps after, which I didn't video because I couldn't get my camera to sit, actually, you know, somewhere to sit where you see the jumps. So yeah, we did a few jumps after, and the small ones were pretty horrible, but she did a couple of nice big jumps. But yeah, it was, yeah. I'm not trying to like make out that my horse is like a bitch and I hate her and stuff, but she's just a wee bit hard to ride. And yeah, she's just got so much energy and it's like, oh, sorry. Yeah, she's just got so much energy and it's so hard to be able to control that without her being a tart. And yeah, especially coming down, like if you get cantering, you come down to trot, she does this real choppy, kind of like, she's real choppy and she just like stops. It was awkward. There was a car behind us. But yeah, she's just, I don't know. She was good, but not as good as I wanted or hoped. So I'm really shaky. But still got one horse to ride. Where are you, Cal? Callie! Ooh, I can't get her. I don't know if you saw her at all. Kind of blends in with the shade, it's annoying. But yeah, still got Callie to ride. Need to wash this girl that I'm still sitting on. Yeah, so we'll do all that and I'll see you soon. If I don't die. See ya. Taxi. So you probably can't tell at the moment, but once we get out, she is so sweaty, and we haven't even worked that long. We probably only worked, I don't know, maybe 45 minutes if that. But yeah, this is what happens every ride that we do. She just sweats so much, and I've had it checked out. Like, it's not a condition, medical condition or anything. She's just a sweat horse. Yeah, she just really sweats bad, as you can tell. but there's not much I can do about it. And no, it's not just because she's got a winter coat. She does it in the summer too, so. And no, it's not because of the heat or anything. It's just, she just sweats. So yeah, so I'm just going to go untick her, give her a wash. Cool. Okay. And then tack up Miss Kelly. So, we have Kelly all tacked up, ready to go. So, same thing, tack, say, standing. Good girl. Her saddle, have no idea what it is. It's just a super old saddle. It's one of my first ever. No, it is my first ever saddle. It's one I used on Missy a lot. As you can tell, when she fell, she scratches and stuff are still there. That was when she fell on the road and got an epileptic fit. So yeah, I don't know the brand. It's about a 17 inch, I think. The stirrup levers are just exactly the same as Texas saddle. They're black, yes, because hopefully I'd be able to buy her a new saddle too, depending if I keep her or not. Another Enzo Graf, hers is a 42. Equestrian Sport purple, it looks navy, but it's purple saddle pad. And stop cribbing. Shire's half pad, that's way too big, but I got it that size because obviously new saddle, blah blah blah. Brown Y or 3-point, whatever you call them, breastplate. And she's got a black bridle, no, I can feel the haters already. Black Enzo, has a real fancy name, but I can't think of it. So, I don't know, but it's got some fancy stitching on it, and very nice, I love it. And then she's just got her Shire's purple brushing boots, or I don't know any other names. I know people call them different, but yeah, we're all shaking today. And Tex is over there drying off. Hello. You ready to go home? Yeah? So we just got back from our ride. Finally got home. And Kelly was absolutely amazing. Yeah, really good. She spooked only about twice. Big spooks at least. Then everything else, she's on the super loose rein. And, you know, wasn't actually worried about anything. So it's actually our first time only having, well, less than at least 10 spooks. So I was really happy about that. Oh, Tex taking over. Little Miss Photogenic. Yes, you are. So yeah, I'm just going to feed these girls. And then that will be them for the day. And yes, Tex is all muddy. She did roll once I let her go. I was going to film it, but... Okay, sorry about that, guys. I ran out of storage. So I had to delete a whole lot of photos and stuff. But I don't know where I got up to until I saw it not recording. Tex! You grump? So, yeah. All I've got to do now is feed them. And then that's them finished. So, what they get is this grain in here. They get about 4 scoops of it. And it's just this Kool-Aid texture feed is what it's called. Just looks like that. And it's really good. I love it. It helps with weight gain. And it doesn't have any high fiber stuff or anything in it. So, your horse isn't getting hot. You know, it doesn't make them get all fizzy and hot. And then they also get this Graze Easy, which has magnesium and stuff in it, and it neutralizes the effect of the grass and diet, improve health and behavior, retain vital minerals for longer useful life. Oh, it's open. So yeah, it smells really good, and it hopefully it'll work. It's my first time ever using.
Okay, so I think I'm gonna end the video here. Sorry, I'm looking at my horse. Don't know. There she is. Hello. Hello. So I'm gonna end it here. Not much else to do, but sorry, this is probably a very boring vlog. I'm probably gonna do another vlog or something like it next time I go to the beach with one of the horses. I really want to take Kelly, but it will just depend really. But yeah, it's usually Tex that goes to the beach. Kelly's still a wee bit green and young for it just at the moment. But yeah, hopefully I'll be able to take her. And hopefully I'll upload something soon. And remember to like, subscribe, and comment for any more suggestions that you guys want. I'm pretty open to doing anything, really. So yeah, bye! Like a bullet train.